Welcome once more, and welcome to everyone who is watching this recording a bit later on. This is another online talk through Guan Kan, which in the first instance was a journal, as well as a little organization here in Perth in Western Australia, for people that are interested in contemporary Chinese art. And Guan Kan have been running a series of talks to accompany the journal. And today we're talking to Li Xinmo. So today I'd like to introduce Sam on my left here. Sam was a student here at the University of West Australia, has graduated it and is now working in the arts here in Perth for regional arts organisations. Tami is a fantastic contemporary photographer, contemporary artist, and exhibits both in Australia and in China, as well as in other parts of the world. She also works as a translator and as one of the prime moving forces here at Guan Kan in establishing our links with that great country and its artists. And today we want to talk to Li Xinmo. Sorry, do you want to translate?
No, it's fine.
Okay, fine. And today we want to introduce the contemporary artist Li Xinmo, who we met in China a couple of years ago now. And we had a fantastic dinner there with Li Xinmo, and she told us all about her exciting work. She's a highly educated artist who is working at the intersections of performance art, feminism, and contemporary art. She also works as a critic and a curator. She graduated from the Tianjin Academy of Fine Arts in 2008 and was based in Beijing, but has recently moved with her school to Chengdu in the south of China, southwest of China. Her works are collected by Ostasia Museet in Sweden, and collectors have her work in Britain, Germany, Switzerland, Singapore, and other parts of the world. She was also a special artist honored by United Nations Women. And also, she also writes as well. She's published articles in places like National Arts, Oriental Art Master, and elsewhere. She's created the feminist exhibition, Heterogeneous Body, Performance Art and Postmodern Theatre at the UCCA, Map and Territory, another show called In China in Germany, and at the German Embassy in Beijing. My God, that's a lot of stuff. I'm sure after Li Xinmo talks to us, we'll be able to talk to her and ask her lots of questions about her multiple practices.
OK， 晚上好，欢迎大家来到观看的第四期讲座。我们观看是在西澳大学成立的一个关于中国当代艺术的学术期刊。我们做主要去我们的那个观看网站可以看到我们的一些关于中国当代艺术的学术研究文章。我们今天在场的三位 Sam、Darren。还有我本身呢，我们是观看的三位主编之一，三位主编，Sam 是以前我们西澳大学的学生，刚毕业，毕业不久，然后现在在博物馆工作，这中间呢是我的导师，然后西澳大学的教授，然后观看，是澳洲，非常有名的一个，研究，社会介入性艺术和土著艺术的，学者。然后我是向晨梅。那关于我呢，我老师介绍了很多，我就不想介绍太多了哈。大家可以去去查我，收入我的名字，可以查到我的作品和我的研究作品。今天我们有幸邀请到中国非常有名的行为艺术家和学与艺术当代艺术研究学者李新墨。来到我们的讲座，参加我们的第四次讲座。那我现在首先介绍一下李新墨他的一个简历。李新墨是1976年出生在黑龙江，然后毕业于天津美院。他的作品被瑞典东方博物馆、泰达当代美术馆 德国、瑞士、新加坡等多个国家美术馆收藏。他同时是一位大学的教授，之前在北京工作，现在搬到了成都。他的主要研究关于的学术文章发表在国家美术、东方艺术家等艺术专业刊物上。他曾经策划过《意在的身体》女性主义艺术展，然后在尤伦斯策划了行为艺术与后现代剧场的展览。他也是地图与疆域国际艺术展的主策展人。今天我们非常有这一个多才多艺的美女艺术家和研究者，今天非常高兴也请到我们的现场。那我们对他的期待和所有的介绍先到这里。我们欢迎李新墨给我们讲解他的作品和研究，然后大家有什么问题的话，在他讲完以后我们可以提出来。多谢，欢迎李新墨。
首先感谢向成美的邀请，就特别感谢就是Darren 博士，能听到吗？还有 Sam， 非常高兴，我们上次就是见到已经很久没有见了，今天很高兴跟大家就是分享一下我的一些艺术的一些创作的一个历程吧。然后大家如果有什么问题的话，我们可以一会儿可以提问啊。
Okay，
怎么样？
Thanks, Guan Kan Journal invited me to come to this talk tonight. I was very happy to see three of you. It was long time before, since last time we met in Beijing, and very happy to have this talk tonight.
Yeah. 下面我就分享一下，共享一下屏幕吧。
Okay, I'm going to share my screen. Can you share the screen, please? Share.
可以看到吗？
可以。
我呢就是先从这个一个展览开始吧。我觉得这个展览呢，这是2015年我是在德国做的一个个展，是用线策划的这个展览。我现在看哈这个展览，就是它有一个特别的一个意义，就是因为就是那个时候2015年的那些作品，就是好像都跟现在有关系。对，我给那个 Tami 留下那个就是翻译的时间，所以我也不会讲太长啊。所以我先从这个展览开始吧。
So I will start with this exhibition that I did in Germany in 2015, curated by Yong Xian. Now I look back this exhibition, I feel it's very special. It has special meaning compared to what happening today. 没关系，你想怎么讲的怎么讲，我可以。
对，这个展览的名字呢，就是当时取的名字叫 Excluded， 就是排斥啊，就是这个名字。当时我创作的一个作品恰恰叫隔离，这个 Insolution， 这个对，这个是当时的一个展览的一个比较重要的作品吧，就是它是装置行为的一个结合。
Okay.Now look back this exhibition, it was quite meaningful looking back there. This exhibition, this project, 这个展览名字叫 Exclusion, right? 是吧？
Exclude 就是排斥，对，但是这个作品的话叫隔离。
Okay, so the exhibition called Exclusion, which means 排斥 in Chinese.And the work, this piece of artwork is called Isolation, which is very like a quarantine today. So we, I think, have special meaning for today. This work is a very important one for that exhibition, I think. And it is a performance installation.
它这个是就是动物的骨头，然后排列起来的，然后上边有一本卡尔马克思的那个《资本论》。然后呢，就是我是制作了一个就是有水的可以盛装水的一个床，我是躺在里面，然后上面有那个血浆，是那个动物的血哈，然后会滴洒下来，就是这个在现场的那个开幕式上做了这样的一个。
So I did this performance installation. There's a book called By the Capitalism by Karl Marx, and those rows are animal bones. I was lying in a blood box, a container full of animal blood, and the on top of the installation, the blood dropping down her body.
这个的话，当时我就在想，就是一个全球化、全球资本化的一个世界，是吧？而且我选这个卡尔马克思，其实对中国它有双重的含义。其实中国就是典型的卡尔马克思，它的共产主义和它的资本主义都在中国实现。 然后呢，其实，在这样的一种就是语境下，其实这个人都是一种病态，或者是一种还有包括这个动物是吧？就是自然界的被摧毁，还有这个人的世界的一种被摧毁的这么一个状态里边啊。所以这个是当时的我的一个潜意识吧，就是潜意识的一种。 创作，就大概勾勒出这样的一些，选择这样一些具有象征性的一些物件，然后呢，把它，放置在一起，然后构成一个可以互相这些材料之间可以互相对话的这么一个，可以就是让人去沉浸其中的一种作品的现场。
In a globalized capitalism, now we are in a globalized capitalism society, especially in China, that it has communism and capitalism, which caused people really abnormal. It's unnatural combination. So I use the nature and the dog bones, and you could feel that the people's maybe humanity and nature were destroyed. This performance, it was a conscious creation, was an object. And material have a dialogue with each other, and this which makes people to think, immerse into it to think.
对，这个当时起了个名字，就叫隔离。因为当时我就想到了那个种族隔离的那个，就是那是灵光一现哈，就是，然后从去年开始，这个隔离这个词就变成了一个非常当下的。 一个词，所以的话，我就翻出这个作品之后，就有一点点，它有点吃惊。我说觉得，哎呀，那个时候就感觉已经预感到现在的这个将要发生什么哈。当然，这个可能也是一种牵强附会，但是它还是跟现在就是正好映射了现在吧。这样的一个隔离的这么一个，还有这种就是全球化的这样的一种问题的出现，是吧？就是其实那个时候的是一种潜意识。
So the title of this work called Isolation, like a quarantine today, it was very surprise for me to look back this work. It was feeling predicting for today, for the today's quarantine and isolation, but for those days more for a racist isolation. Now I think it's like a reflect for what the globalization problem is, but maybe it is not very natural or to say that it's a prediction for today, but maybe for my consciousness later, from the layer of consciousness, I think it's reflect for the today's situation.
然后呢，就是第二个作品呢，就是这个。然后呢，就这段时间，那个阿富汗，就是大家知道那个塔利班又重新控制这个阿富汗，然后那个阿富汗这些妇女，我看到这些新闻，其实，因为这就是我的生活哈，就是我们每天的生活。我觉得我作为艺术家的话，我的所有的体验其实都是从生活中来的，就是什么东西对我就是。 产生震撼，我可能就会就是做这个作品，就会把它变成一种就是艺术。那当时其实15年哈，那个时候还没有发生这些事情，就是那是我在德国看到的最多的就是这样蒙着这种黑布的这种就是阿拉伯的女性，就是她，因为她们是在德国的那个大街上哈，就经常看到，所以给我的那个我在之前的经验里边是很少见到的，所以尤其是第一次我去德国的时候，就是那个印象特别深。我就在想这世界上为什么还有这样的女性哈，所以的话，其实当时是基于我在德国的一段感受，就是对这个阿拉伯人，就是这些女性。 这种戴着面罩的女性，就是对他们那种直观的感受，然后我做了这样的一个作品，其实是一系列的哈，就是讨论这个宗教与女性的，就是这个是其中的一个，就是戴着面纱的这个，然后后边是灯光，然后呢就是上边就是她的脸上都是有很多的针孔哈，用针刺穿的这个脸部。
Okay, this work I did in 2015 when I was living in Germany. I saw lots of women from in Germany with their body and eyes, head all covered up, walking on the street. This was surprising and astonished for me because I didn't have this strong experience. I didn't have this experience before I went to Germany. So I feel this that impression for me is very strong. It's this work is a feeling, a strong, a direct feeling for me to reflect what I experienced in Germany about Afghanistan, Arabic women's life. This work is about, is discussing religion and females. You can see that there's lots of needle holes on her face, on her scarves, on this painting. Now we say today there's big problem that in Afghanistan, what happens today and the Taliban controlled Afghanistan, what the women will suffering from this situation today. This work in 2015 is reflecting about my experience in Germany, what I saw. This is also another type of isolation. That scarf on her face is isolation which separates the woman with to the world.
这个就是它是一个系列的，就是是关于这个伊斯兰的，这个是古兰经，古兰经那个文字没有了，我把它也是扎成了很多的这种洞哈，然后呢就上边是一个羊头，这个羊头其实这个羊是牺牲哈，牺牲的意思啊，其实它就是用动物，其实女性跟动物，都是处于一种被牺牲的这么一个。 处境里面。
Okay, this actually is from the same theory, same series. I used a sheep skull to create this body of work. There's a sheep's sheep skull, and actually it's discussing about you know, women, female, females and animals is in a situation that being sacrificed, and the skull actually it's like a symbolize sacrifice.
这个是也是这个作品的一部分，这是就是它钉在墙上的哈，这个古兰经还有这个羊驼，另外的一个面墙，这个展览的空间就有点像个监狱一样的哈，所以的话它的那种氛围就会有一种这种就是会跟这个场景也会结合在一起，就是这个作品其实跟这个空间有关系的。
How this work actually is very much attached to this venue, because this venue was looking like a prison, a jail, and used the sheep skull nailed onto the wall, and also the Muslim Bible together nailed onto the wall.
哦，对，这个也是当时的一个作品吧。这个当然是我的一个期待哈，就是，这个可以接受到从天上落下来的那种光辉，但是是什么这个，这个只是一种期待是吧？就是能希望能够平等或者怎么样，或者它也可以没意义哈。这个作品其实当时的一个，对，就是。 就是这一个系列的一个部分吧，就是它可能会更加温暖一些。So
this work is part of the theory. It's just my expectation and my hope to what happened to this work. Use my hand to accept some lighting. From all to hope there's equality, or maybe there's no meaning, but it's just my hope and my expectation.
这个也是这次那这个展览里边的另外一个作者现场行为，就是他是关于身体的啊，就是经常是会，比如说中国的历史是吧？像文革或者是像现在的网暴是吧？其实我觉得都是存在这个问题，就是一群人，对一个人的。 就是身体的，就是你的精神的一种，暴力。它这个的话是我发给这个每个观众一个夹子，然后这些夹子都是夹在我的身上，然后就他们最后会一起把这些夹子就是拉掉。所以的话，这个是一个就是关于，其实就是关于这个众人对个体的一个暴力的。其实这个也非常当下哈，就是特别像现在我看到这个网暴。 网络暴力就是的确是很像文革的那种感觉，就是一个人经常是在无数人的这种口水里边就销声匿迹了哈，就是这种。所以的话，可能这个作品的话，对现在想想也是很当下哈，就是也很跟当下有关系。但是同时它也是跟女性的身体有关系，比如说你这个你的观看是吧？就是他者的这种评论。 社会这种对女性的这种身材啊、外貌的这种观看，其实也是另外一种伤害吧。OK,
so this work I did, 你什么时候做的这个事？
This
exhibition, I did this performance on the opening exhibition opening. It's talk about violence to the individuals. You know, this work I give it was called a clip, right?
Yes.
So I give the clips to the people around me, and they put that on my body. And at the end, everybody takes the clip straight off at the same time. And you know, this work actually is talking about the group of people have violence on the individuals. Then we can talk about the history that the Cultural Revolution, and at the moment was the online violence. You could say that the group of people and the collective people have violence on individuals. And you know, like the online violence, online violence that individuals despairing because of people's comments. And it's very much reflecting for what happening today, that females, women's living situation, that lots of people comment on women's appearance and people's women's looks. It's that work is dealing with these kind of topics.
这些我跟现在给大家看的其实都是这一同一个展览的哈，就是这个展览，我从这个展览讲起的。这个作品的话，其实就是叫这个笔埋在伤口里，就是说那个时候我就已经强烈的感受到这种，就是你没办法说话哈，就是你是没有言论的自由，所以的话只能是，就是这个笔就像一个隐喻，就是它只能埋在这个伤口里面，其实你是无法言说的。 其实这个是我现在就越来越强烈的感觉，就是你可能就拿笔写一写，但是你还不能说出来，是吧？你都不能讲很多的事情，所以的话就是，其实那个时候我已经有这种，就是已经有很深的这种感觉，但是现在会更强烈哈。就现在我看这些作品，的话，可能更适合，就是越来越适合当下了。
So this work had existed at this same exhibition, and that a pen buried underneath the scar, the wounded part, the wound, the wound. And it's just like a metaphor for the freedom of speech, that our situation, we don't have the freedom of speech. And sometimes maybe we just could write about it, but we couldn't speak out. Those days in 2015, I have the experience, I have the feeling, have had the sensitivity about the freedom of speech. But at the moment, I just feel that the situation is stronger and stronger.
这个就是叫无名者肖像这个做了一个系列的，也都是这个展览哈。然后呢，就是这个用这个横七竖八这个针线，然后穿过这个脸，然后这个是就是画画跟装置吧，然后还有包括这些绘画，这个都是一个系列的叫无名者肖像啊。然后的话呢，就是。 就是无名者，其实就是你看这个历史，它会因为这个一个事件、一个事变、一场战争，就会死很多人啊，就会很多人落难。但是这些人的话，其实你不知道名字的，在监狱里边的人也是没名字的，都是一些数字。其实，在网络的时代，我们现在也是人也变得越来越是没有名字哈，就是都是最后也变成一串数字。所以的话呢，这个其实就是跟战争。 跟这些有关系哈，这个可能是我不知道哈，我就是一出手就是这种感觉的，我很难，画出快乐的感觉哈，这个很奇怪，这就是我的一种心象嘛，就是内心的一种相貌啊。
Okay, this this series work is called The Anonymous, that, you know, it's kind of commemorate those people who died in those events or wars, and those people at the end, they don't have their name right down, just become a figure. For me, I just for me, it's hard for me to paint out very happy face. I could say lots of disastrous or the dark side of the experience or society or events or wars. It's just like the image of, you know, it's soul image, image of my soul, that I can say the history and lots of people died without leaving their name or without their name writing down. And this body of work, you could say that for me to commemorate those people who didn't have a name left behind.
这些作品都是用这个针线，因为也很多女性用女艺术家用这个针线。 线呢之类的，反正我用的都是这种比较残酷的感觉，就是残酷的一种表达方式，就是我很难就是把它唯美化哈，就是这个可能是我的一个人的一种特质吧啊，做艺术它会带进来，这种个人的特质其实都会带到这个作品里边。
So this work actually is made with the needles and thread that, you know, lots of female artists use needles and thread to create artwork. And for me, it's really hard for me to create very beautiful images. I mean, like just pretty images. And from the work for me looks really cruel, and that's how I see the world and the society.
对，我对这个的话，其实就是作为一个开始，就是说我介绍一个这个展览，大家可以看一下。就是我在等我回头看这个这些作品的时候，我就在想这个，哎呀，就是一个当下，就是那个时候把当下的这个所有的我感受到的这个。 国家的这些，就所有的体验，可能我都做出来，或者是世界范围内的话，因为我也不只是关注中国的事情，所以的话呢，就是很像当下，比如说这个瘟疫是吧？对动物的迫害，然后的话还有隔离，还有这个阿富汗。 就是女性的问题，还有中国的这个，就是自由的这个，就是问题，还有这个言论是吧？你不可以讲话，然后的话还有这种，就是这种暴力是吧？群体对个人暴力，其实这个就是我每天看现在的这个现在哈，就是我觉得就是真的是就是当下啊。
Okay, now look back to that work I did in 2015 that is really much reflecting the current situation. For example, the pandemic, the isolation, the quarantine, and to the suppression on animals, and also the situation in Afghanistan and the freedom of speech in China, the problems that we could not speak freely, and also the violence that the collective group of people had had violence on individuals. So my work is very much it's a prediction, and also look back, it's a reflect response to the living situation of the current humanity and the human living situation.
然后的话，其实这个做，比如说，也可以说是社会，我也很难说是社会介入，是吧？我觉得，我的关注的东西呢，有个体的，有我个人的部分，但是也有我对周边的这个我的生活的环境，就是这个社会政治环境，政治环境，其实这些都是与我密不可分的哈，我没有觉得他们是就是。 有什么特别的地方，我觉得这就是我的生活，所以的话呢，其实我关注这个社会政治，我不是把它当做一个名目或者是一个说艺术的一个概念，或者是一个你要去达到什么的一个东西哈，就是说其实它就是我的真切的一种感受，就是感知，而且我也喜欢把这个，我也倾向于把自己的一些个人的体验放进去，因为我觉得这个作品就它最后的这个感染力还是挺重要的，就是它这个作品首先是要触动我自己，然后的话呢，我觉得这个时候我才可以去做它。 其实这些作品的话，它还不是我是怎么做哈，其实只是它是从我的这种体验里边，从我的感受里边生长出来的啊，所以的话呢，我觉得，这个是我对这个艺术与社会政治的一个理解，就是他们不是一个分离的，就是它跟我或者是我们的生活不是分离的，这个就是我们所在的这个环境。
Okay, this this work, maybe for the work I did, maybe I also could call it called socially engaged arts. My work actually respond to the environment and the society, the political environment we are living in. It's not just about my personal life, but also about the situation, the society, political society where we are. And I'm not just treat my work as my personal feelings, but also respond to the society. The work is coming from my true feelings and my true experience. And I always like to put my experience, my feeling, my sensitivity in this work. And all the work they need, I should be moved first before I create this work or after create this work. From the point of my personal experience and feeling, and I think art is not disconnected from the society. It cannot be separated from the society. It is part of the society that we respond to where the situation we are in.
因为内容讲不了太多，就我们双语的话，其实这时间就会焦紧张，所以的话我把这个时间会缩短一点，就下边就大概介绍一下。这个的话是一个对，这是在一个剧场里边的一个表演，就是在读一个其实跟集权啊、暴力啊这些有关系的一首诗，然后呢就是有两个人就会把我这个用图就是埋起来啊，这一会儿大家可以看一下录像，对，这个可以翻一下。
Okay, this actually work was created in a theater that I was lying on a bed, created a bed, and I was reading a book that's about violence and extremism and, you know, totalitarianism, and people spread the soil to bury me, and we could see the videos later.